Hey guys, 𝐁𝐬𝐬 here. Welcome back to the channel. Today I will show you how to convert your footage and make them super slow motion in just a few clicks. So here we have a preview and you may not see much of a difference, but if I play it back with a slower speed, then you can see that the left one has a much lower frame rate and the right one is the one with slow motion applied. And in this video, we are going to use a software called Flowframes, and it's a free software, so I will put a link to their website in the description below, so feel free to check it out. And note that the installation process might take a while depending on your machine. And after you have installed the software, let's run it, and here's the main interface. And we're going to focus on the second tab here. And there are only a few settings that I will cover in this video to get you started. So the first one is to browse video. And basically you choose the video that you would like to slow down. And then we're going to look at the output FPS and speed settings. And usually as you have selected the video, some settings should be detected automatically. So for example, the footage that I have selected has a frame rate of 60. And the second field is how many times that you want it to be slowed down. So here you can choose between 2, 4, 8, and 16 times. So basically it will multiply 60 with 16. And in this case, the output FPS is 960. So basically that's how many frame rates the result will have. So you are getting 960 FPS from a 60 FPS video. Finally, in the last field, you can choose how your result should be played back. So by default, the normal speed is selected, but you can choose 2x, 4x, or 8x. And if you select 8x, then you will divide it by 8, and the result will have a frame rate of 120. Or you can also import the resulting footage into After Effects and slow it down even more. So that's basically how you turn your footage into slow motion. And remember that it may not always work for all footage, depending on how much motion you have. So experiment around. And if you want to use this for anime clips, then you will also need to extract frames. And I have another video on how to do that, and the link is in the description below. And if you'd like to know more about the other settings in this software, let me know in the comment section and I'll make a dedicated video. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.